I'm not sure if you saw my video about PA6, carbon fiber versus glass fiber. And there at the end I mentioned that this is the strongest nylon I tested so far. Well, not anymore. PPA-CF is stronger. Welcome to another Bambu Lab filament testing video. This is PPA-CF, a premium fiber reinforced nylon filament or polyamide. The price is quite big, $150, well, depend on the country, of course, but this is only for 0.75 kilograms spool. But according to the website, it has metallized strength, industrial grade precision and great dimensional stability, stable in humid conditions, this means great for the water applications too, and temperature resistant filament, this is typical for the most of the nylons. I already tested their PA6 filaments and I was amazed about the strength of those filaments. One of the strongest nylons I tested so far, and that's why I'm excited about this filament, because theoretically this should be even more stronger. We have some requirements. Of course, we need a hardened steel nozzle and the extruder. According to the website, the 0.6 mm nozzle is recommended, but it should work with 0.4 mm too, and this is what I will test in this video. It must be dried 100 and 140 degrees Celsius between 8 to 12 hours. Now this is too much. I will dry it maybe 2 or 3 hours, but the printing will be from the filament dryer too. The print temperature is between 280 and 310 degrees Celsius and the bed temperature between 100 and 120 degrees Celsius, but I will use the different settings in the Bambu Studio and properly I will use the engineering plate with some glue stick on it. They take a packaging very seriously. This kind of packaging is much better against the moisture compared to those regular foils. And this bag is resealable, so cut it above this ceiling line. Let's start with the drying. The oven is preheated to 120 degrees Celsius. And I will follow its weight every half hour using this analytical scale. I presented it in one of my previous videos. And one more time reminder, don't forget to cut it above the ceiling line, because this side is smaller compared to this one. It arrives on this cardboard spool. On spool we have the information to dry the filament for optimal print quality, but we don't have the information what is the maximum temperature for the spool. 955.30 grams. It's time for the half hour measuring. 954.42 grams. It's time for 2 hours measuring. 952.70. Even after 2 hours of drying, I can see the constant change in the weight. This means it still has a lot of removable moisture in it, and I will continue with the drying. Only now, after 4 hours of drying, I can see some slowing down in the weight loss, so maybe soon it will make sense to stop the drying and start the printing, maybe after 1 hour. Of course, it will not be perfectly dried, but I will not get significantly better results if I dry it, I don't know, 4 hours more. And the last measuring after 5 hours. 950.86, so definitely it slowed down with the weight loss. It's ready for printing. Later I will analyze this. Actually, I can analyze it now. We can see that the drying slowed down. The latest change in the mass was only 0.13 grams. And I calculated it. If it would be perfectly dry, it would have 950.12 grams. And if I would dry it 10 hours, in that case the weight would be 950.31 grams. So as you can see, using this kind of analytical scale, you can save a lot of drying energy. And this is the calculated moisture, and I have two variants here. In the first one, I predicted that all the change in the mass was in the filament only, and this cardboard spool don't have any moisture before this drying, which is probably incorrect. In second variant, I predicted that it has the same amount of the moisture, but I believe that the real conditions are somewhere between. Anyway, approximately in 5 hours I could reduce the moisture from 0.6% to 0.09, but of course this can vary depending on the start conditions. End of the filament was glued. Let's see how brittle is this material. Ooh, very brittle. The filament dryer is preheated. PPA-CF, it's in the list. The filament is changed and now let's start the printing. And these are my typical test objects, and let's see the settings. 290 on the nozzle, 100 on the bed, and 8 will be the flow rate, and these are the part cooling settings. Engineering plate with the glue on it. The start looks good, and if the bed adhesion will be okay, then it will be fine printing. The first layer inspection, but it's completely fine. This is the second layer, and now it's printing on the full speed. And this is the time-lapse video, 15 minutes in only a few seconds, and each object was perfectly straight, no warping at all. Let's take a closer look. Okay. These are really nice printings. I really wish to print a bench with this, but it would be too expensive. Too expensive, you say? Then I need one. I'm curious about those overhangs with the minimal part cooling, but it looks okay. And this bench is almost absolutely perfect. And the only error I can see here, and I'm not quite sure because it looks like the part cooling is maybe not enough because it is almost completely disabled, but usually it would appear somewhere here. If somebody can recognize this error, then please let me know. There will be one more important test here for me. 919.42. End of the filament is good and it was measured together with this sticker. I want to see how good is this storing method in the vacuum. So I measure the spool now and I will measure it after 2 weeks because I will not start the mechanical testing yet. I will wait at least 1 week so they will absorb some moisture and they will go closer to the stable state. And then for the creep test I need at least 5 days. So I measure again this spool in 2 weeks from now. But for you this means at the end of the video. Now after 10 days I can start the mechanical testing, but I want to show you this. I already measured several objects. And this design dimension of this object is 80 millimeters. It has great dimensional accuracy. I already measured several test objects. This one for the temperature test is 60 millimeter in design. Almost perfect. The tensile test and the maximum on this scale is 200 kilograms. I hope it will be enough. Printed in horizontal position, and for the reference, you can see the PPA-CF numbers. And this is the average value, very strong material. Layer adhesion with vertically printed objects. Good, but compared to the XY, much weaker. Good layer adhesion, but extremely strong in XY direction on the tensile test. This means that you have to pay attention to the design because it is much stronger along the XY axis compared to the Z axis. For shear test, I have the horizontally and vertically printed test objects with the same dimensions. I'm starting with vertically printed, where the layer adhesion is important. And I believe that 200 kilograms may be not even be enough. So I'm switching to this crane scale with the maximum of 500 kilograms. But I also have my limit here. It's better if you don't see my suffering, but I never tested so strong material in this testing. My maximal gravity force multiplied with 2.5 was not enough to shear this test object. Maybe I should stop doing these shear tests with horizontally printed test objects. I mean, probably nobody wants to see this. How boring is this? No break. Please, tell me that you agree with me. Very strong in both directions, even printed vertically, but this printed horizontally is extremely strong. The torque or twist test, where I have a horizontally and vertically printed test objects with the same dimensions. This one is printed in horizontal position, and usually I try to record the load at 90 degree rotation. This broke a little bit earlier. For this printed vertically, I forgot to press the record button, but it was 1.9 Newton meters and it breaks suddenly. In this test also very strong material. I couldn't make a 90 degree rotation. I was very close to it with this horizontally printed test object, but maybe this is not a bad property. I mean, it resists to these loads without bigger deformation. And now 3-point bending test to see how stiff is this material. And these are the loads which I replaced one by one, and I will measure the deformation after 1, 30 and 60 seconds. This is a speed up time-lapse video. The load is 1.25 kilograms, 2.5, 5, and pay attention, no change during the time under constant load. This is 10 kilograms and no changes at all, very stiff material with very minimal deformation. And immediately after I remove the load, it gets back the original shape, no problem with deformation at all. The temperature test in the oven, and I have two materials here. This is PPA-CF and this is PET-CF. Now, both materials can resist to temperatures above 200 degrees Celsius according to specifications, which is very close to the upper limit of my equipment, but approximately at this temperature I will stop the experiment and I want to see how hard are these materials. One interesting thing I noticed, on nylon I can move much easier this metallic nut compared to the PET-CF, so here we have much bigger friction compared to this one. Not a scientific approach, but let's try to measure it somehow. But it's time for the temperature test. This is speed up time lapse video, and the PET-CF started with deformation at 120 degrees Celsius, and on the nylon you will see it is completely straight, no deformation at all. 207 degrees, I'm stopping the experiment now. And interesting that according to specification it could withstand the temperatures above 200 degrees Celsius, this PET-CF. PPA is completely hard. PET-CF is hard too, but it has quite big deformation. But this PPA nylon is in perfect shape, no deformation, and the surface is in perfect quality. The creep test the deformation under the constant load of 1.25 kilograms. And I will do parallel this test. This is the PPA-CF nylon and this is PET-CF. And I will measure the distance between two reference surfaces. I already measured them, just a slightly more deformation on the PET compared to the PPA. This is a good sign. Even after one day visual, I cannot see any additional deformation on them. I already measured them and the additional deformation of the PPA compared to the day is zero. This means initial deformation is only 0.1 millimeters. Now let's remove the load. There is not even measurable permanent deformation on this test object. The impact test with this half kilogram hammer. And the filament itself is very brittle. We will see if that is the case with the C-deformated objects too. The PS6 nylon filaments were quite brittle, which is unusual for the nylons. Well, we will see how the PPA performs here. PPA, zero position. At the first look, it is tougher material compared to the PS6, but let's analyze the footage. Only now I can see that it is very similar to PS6-CF, which is a tougher material compared to the PLA or PETG, but more brittle compared to the average nylon I tested so far. And now the results. This Excel table you can download from my techfan.com website, and on this sheet you can see the information about the drawing. For my veteran supporters, I'm adding this line to that summary table so they can easily compare these results to any from my previous video. But I will include here the results for PS6-CF. And I'm starting with the creep test. This is the measured dimension of two reference surfaces. And we can see that almost no deformation on PPA-CF. And that creeping the difference between 2 days we can see on this graph. I think this is the best material in this test so far. On tensile test with horizontally printed test objects, this PPA-CF is very strong, but on a layer adhesion, this is not bad layer adhesion, but compared to the XY direction load, this is weaker. On the shear stress, incredible, almost 300 kilograms, and I couldn't break this test object. And with the vertically printed test objects, it was a little bit weaker compared to the PS6 because of that weaker layer adhesion. But there is a reason for this layer adhesion, I will talk about it in conclusions part. On 3-point bending test, this is the deformation under these loads after 30 seconds. Smaller values are better, but maybe this is more interesting, where we can see the deformation of these loads after 130 and 60 seconds. And look at this, not only that the values are smaller, less deformation, but also they are completely horizontal. Even under 10 kilograms, no additional deformation during the time on this test object. The torque or twist test, and usually I want to record the load at 90 degree rotation and the maximal load, but with these horizontally printed test objects, I couldn't really make 90 degree turn. It was very close to it, so this number will be added to that summary table for my Patreon supporters. And with the vertically printed test objects, it was the same load like with the PS6-CF, and it breaks suddenly. On isod impact test, it was very similar to the PS6 material. It is tougher compared to the PLA and PETG, but more brittle compared to the average nylon. And on a temperature test, it performed really good in this test, and I stopped the experiment on 208 degrees Celsius, but probably it could go even higher.
When I showed the results to my friend Everson from GeekDetour, his first comment was, oh, that it has weak layer adhesion. And actually, this Superman with the kryptonite as a weak point was his idea for the thumbnail. Mine was a little bit different. But actually, this is not really a weak layer adhesion. It is good. It is not excellent, but this is good layer adhesion. It looks weak because it is very strong in X and Y direction. Now, I think even this layer adhesion we can improve, because if you pay attention, the recommended print temperature is between 280 and 320 degrees Celsius. And the default setting was 290 degrees Celsius. And I noticed that the companies don't really like to set the default temperatures to the maximum limit of the printer, with the reason I had some bad experience with Prusamark 3 when I tried to print on 300 degrees Celsius. And I believe that printing on 3 or 310 degrees Celsius, it can have much better layer adhesion. And soon I will have the review of the TD Plus 4, and it is able to print on 370 degrees Celsius. So here I will do another test with this to see if I can improve that layer adhesion by printing on higher temperatures. In the meantime, the PET-CF testing is finished too. Only I need a few days for the processing the results and for video editing. And if you want to get notifications about that upload, don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell button too, because in most cases, my videos are not recommended by YouTube algorithm. So from those average, let's say 4 or 5,000 views, 70% are those who click that notification bell button too. Not sure what is the reason, but be careful because you may easily skip that new upload. Until then, thank you for watching and happy printing. Ah yes, I have to measure this spool. I know that the vacuum is still inside because the pump turns off very quickly. Oh, 920.48, okay. This means during these 2 weeks it absorbed 1 gram of the moisture. I thought this number will be much smaller. I think it's time to test different storing methods too. But it also means that I have to dry this filament every time I want to use it. But this is enough for this video. Thank you for watching and don't forget notification bell button if you want to get notifications about new uploads. See you in my next video. Bye.